Hello and welcome. My name is Patrick. I'm from the Ford Events team, and I'm here with TrustFord today to talk about the all-new Mustang Mach-E. The model we got here is the all-wheel drive extended range, and it happens to be in absolute black. I'm going to start at the corner here, work around the vehicle, and if you want to ask any questions afterwards, just write into the dealerships and I'm sure they'll be able to answer any questions I don't cover at this point. So let's start here. It is a Mustang. It is a performance vehicle first and foremost. It's weighted to the ground by 600 kilos of fantastic battery here, and this particular model weighs about 2.5 tons. So it's going nowhere but in a straight, perfect line. Here we go. Start of the corner here, we've got the tri-bar lighting, which is a signature of the Mustang. And of course, we've got the LED lights here, which are sequential for hazard and indicating. Lots of sensors down here, front and side, and the sides there. And of course, you've got sensors up in the screen here as well. They all work together to provide you with comfort and safety, identifying pedestrians, pre-collision, and all those things that make life in driving much more safer. I'm going to the front of the vehicle here as well. No grille. It seems like an obvious thing to say, but there's no grille because there's no engine. What I'll do normally is I would normally go to this passenger seat, double click on the lever there, and the bonnet will open. But for my purposes, I've taken the clip out, so it wouldn't normally open like this. Well, look at this. There you are. Ta-da, no engine. 81 litres of washable, drainable space. You can take this section out here if you want and fill it with ice, maybe a dirty football kit, all the things that you don't want to be seen in the vehicle. You've got all your cables come with the vehicle here as well. This is a 3-pin, plus a clamping socket, so if you're in the wilderness as well, you can actually plug in. And of course, you've got the wall socket there as well. I won't lift the lid off here, but behind here, you have got a small battery, a system battery, and there's very few moving parts. So you've got the fluid for your brakes, and of course, a bit of coolant there as well. But essentially, no moving parts. So that means you only have to service this vehicle every 18,000 miles or 2 years. I'm just gonna close the lid there now and bring this lid down here. I said there's no vents. There are, there's some down here. These are called active aero vents. And what they do is they provide aerodynamicity for the vehicle. You could say they cool the brakes and they cool the batteries, but in actual fact, the batteries are liquid cooled. It really is providing you that wonderful, smooth and aerodynamic movement. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna move around here and I'm going to talk about the 19-inch wheels and the red calipers. Okay, so here we have the 19-inch wheels on this particular model. On the rear-wheel drive standard battery, you have 18-inch. We've got 19-inch wheels here today. Red calipers. Now, the reason I mention them, one, they look lovely, but the other thing is, as I mentioned, with the engine not being there and being battery-operated, not having any moving parts, 2 year servicing. Also, if you use the one-pedal drive system, you literally don't use the brakes. The motors actually slow the vehicle down, your brake lights come on so other drivers know exactly what's going on. But the great thing is all that power that you would have wasted going here by using the brakes goes back into the battery. So you're regenerating energy and you're saving your money by not having to change those brake pads. Great, so we've done the front of the vehicle, we've done the wheels. Now let's look at getting into the vehicle. If you had your key fob or your phone in your pocket, this vehicle would recognize you and have everything set. So your favorite seating position, how you want it heated, radio stations, phone calls, journeys, all those things preset to the individual. But if you don't have your key fob with you or you don't have your phone with 4-pass loaded, don't worry, we've got a fantastic system here. What happens is, if you haven't got those, you press in your secret code and you actually get into the vehicle. It actually works great in actual fact, when you think about it. If you're away out of the country on business, maybe you've left a book in the car, you can phone home, give a temporary code, that person can get into the vehicle, get that book or that drawing, whatever you need, and send it on to you. So those dramas are averted. Whilst we're outside the vehicle, let's talk about the wing mirrors. Fantastic piece of kit here as well. You've got indicators, blind spot indicators, you've got the pool lamp, foot puddle lamp with the Mustang on it, you've got the cameras, we have cameras front, back and both sides, and also these are heated and foldable. A great piece of kit. And let's break down the logo for you too as well. The Mach-E, Mach Electric, for all-wheel drive with the extended battery. Okay, so we're inside the vehicle now. Let me take you through this step by step. 8-way adjustable electronic seats there. You've also got Sensico leather seats. It's not real leather, but it feels, it smells like leather. It's really, really comfortable. It's lovely. There's also red stitching on this particular model. They're heated and they are cool, both the driver and the passenger seat. On the steering wheel, which is heated in the same leather finish, You've got a fantastic cluster here giving you great information in really crisp graphics. All the information, battery speed, etc. Of course, the heart of the vehicle, hopefully you can see that, is the 15.5 inch screen, which is the largest in the industry. Essentially, that has all the information. You can spend days, if you like, planning and adjusting the information there you need. But the great thing about it, if you're like me and you haven't got a great attention span, what you can actually do is put some basic information in there and this vehicle will learn all about you. It's full of artificial intelligence. So every call you make, every drive you make, every stop you make, all those things that you do by habit, change radio stations, this vehicle will know that. And as you develop over the weeks, it will get more and more. The great thing about it also, after you finish this vehicle, maybe after 3 or 4 years, all that information could be passed to your next vehicle. I can't think of anything more exciting. In the center of the vehicle there, you might see a flat area. You can change or charge your mobile phones there. And also this comes with its own internal SIM card. So in essence, 10 people could use this as a hotspot anywhere in the country. The scenario I always give is you can drive to the country with your boot space, your 81 liters full of ice and lovely drinks and lovely food. And then you can really show off and let everybody use your vehicle as a way of communicating or playing their games. We've got the one pedal drive. You might notice down there, you might be able to see two pedals. You've got the brake pedal and of course the accelerator pedal, and that's that accelerator pedal basically is the pedal you would use to drive the vehicle. You may never have to touch the brake again apart from emergencies. If you want to, you can actually use the L button in the middle of the vehicle here, and that means on longer journeys, similar to the one pedal drive, it's like this vehicle has no gears, but as you come off the accelerator, it feels like you're dropping gear and you're actually sending power back to the battery. A really fantastic, sophisticated piece of equipment and a lovely, comfortable interior. So let's recap. We've been at the front of the vehicle, we've seen the shark nose, we've seen no grills, we've seen the 19-inch wheels, and we've also pointed to and discussed the driver's position. Here we're at the back of the vehicle. I'm going to say some obvious stuff here. There's no engine because there's no exhaust either, and that's brilliant. So you've got no tunnel down here, so three people can sit very comfortably in here with their feet on the floor. And what's really, really good, it's also easy to see on this with this absolute black, but you can see the fast back shape of the original Mustang here. What they've cleverly done is created headroom using the UV roof here. So even people that we've had in this vehicle, 6'3", 6'5", they got in, feet on the floor, nice and comfortable, and they've got the headroom as well, which is so, so important. Again, lovely and comfortable, and you've got your USB connectors in the back here as well as in the front. The seats do fold forward, 60-40, nice and flat, but we'll go on to that in just a moment. Okay, so here we are at the back of the vehicle. Again, I've got to point these out, the tri-bar lighting with the sequential indicators, absolutely wonderful, the statement of a Mustang. And of course, don't forget the haunches here. They've tried to include as much of the Mustang in the design of this wonderful SUV as they possibly could. Now, if I had my key fob in my pocket, which I don't, I could wave my foot underneath here, it does work, and the rear tailgate would actually come up. Little camera in there as well. So you've got your parcel shelf there, which can be tucked away. And also inside, people love this, is you've got two levels for your storage. If you have it at the higher level, when the seats are folded flat, you actually get a flat surface in there as well. You've got a nice little light in there and a 12 volt power supply there, plus some harnesses here as well. So great space, 402 litres of the back space here. If you push those seats down to say 60-40 flat, you get 1420 litres. Great space, and don't forget those 81 litres in the front as well. So let's talk charging. Everyone's talking about charging. Simply press this little, of course it wouldn't work the first time there for me, would it? You've got universal type 2 charging here. You've got a little indicator, I love this, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. You don't really need it, it's nice to see because you have all the information in the palm of your hand or indeed on your screen in the car. And then just below here, we have the fast charging, CCS as it's known, combined charging system. Now, I'm gonna give you some figures here, but don't be terrified. This vehicle, this particular one, this is the all-wheel drive extended, has a range of 335, it's got two motors. If you want more range, you go for the rear-wheel drive extended, you get 379. Now, if you manage to drain this vehicle down to zero, which will be a feat in itself, what you'd have to do is obviously recharge it. Now, it comes with all the plugs. So say, for example, you're at a friend's house, you could plug into a 3-pin socket there, but it would take a long time to recharge this vehicle. The best way is go to your wall box, ideally at home, or indeed at a local charger, pop it into the type 2 fitting here, which is universal, and you can get those through Ionity and all the charging points around the country. And it will take about 10 hours to charge it up from zero. Remember, you've probably done nearly 400 miles now. So that's a long journey. So you'd need a break anyway, but 10 hours will be an overnight charge. But even better than that, you can go now to a charging station along the road. There's lots of them available and the numbers are growing. Across Europe alone, there's 155,000 points. Think about that. And in the UK, we're looking at 10,000 plus and growing on a daily basis. 45 minutes to recharge this vehicle to full. So you can get on your way. And after a 400-mile drive, 350, 400-mile drive, you kind of want at least 45 minutes to recuperate. So no problem at all there. So Type 2. It's got the three pin as a backup, and you've got your CCS charging there. So it goes from 30 hours if you wanted to charge on three pin, 10 hours on your Type 2, and 45 minutes on your CCS. On Ionity as well, you've also got a fantastic facility. If you've got 10 minutes spare, pop in your fast charger, and you've got 73 miles in just 10 minutes. So I hope that was helpful. Let's just have a recap. We've been to the front of the vehicle with the sensors and no grills and air vents. We've done the 19-inch reels with the calipers. We've also been in the driver's seat. We've been in the back of the vehicle as well with all that lovely space in that headroom. We've been to the tailgate, which is automatic and plenty of space. You can fold the seats down, give you 1,420 litres of space. And we've been down here to all important charging points. Hopefully that's answered most of your questions. But as I say, if you have any, contact any of the dealerships. They've all been trained, they know what they're talking about, and they'd be delighted to see you.